Hello everyone and welcome in. And thank you, Johnston. Well, Johnston fan, for your follow last night after I logged off. Thank you very much. So I hope everyone is doing well on this Friday. I know I am now. I do apologize, I had to take my contacts out, so stuck with wearing glasses for the moment. So let me go ahead and do our usual to get the doffs going. Recruitment has ranked up, nice. And of course, oh, there it is. Hello, Rev. Welcome in. I hope your stream's doing well. And this will probably be my last day of wearing latex for a little bit. I have just ran out of dressing aid. So I have to go place an order. And Max, did I hear Cynthia say you're having a Fortnite tournament? If you are, you're probably a little too busy to answer there, so I do apologize about that. Oh, Overwatch. Okay. Well, the way my ears were ringing, kind of hard to tell sometimes. But I hope it's going well for you. I'm just grinding a season pass of Fortnite. Okay. Well, you go grind that, buddy. And I know tonight we'll be finishing the Delta story arc. should say the Delta Quadrant story arc. Which I am glad, because I hate this one song, and the only song there is. Or music, not song. Ad break, I am here. Okay, yep, I gotcha. So how's your day going, Max? If I can call you Max, if you're fine with that. I never really asked you what you wanted to be called. So I do apologize for that. Doesn't matter to me, some people call me Rev, Wraith, Max, my old user Frylock from Aqua Team. Okay, okay. Yeah, I know you're usually an easygoing guy. But I just wanted to make sure. Oh, I didn't do my fleet stuff today, this morning. I should slap myself silly for that. Any that needs a new one. Not as of yet. Okay. Let's go with what's left behind.
Admiral Tuvok would like you to join his team as they study the mysterious artifact you found on Vardwar Prime. Meet with them in the Nal Shaddan system.
Understood, Admiral.
There's something interesting.
We be on our way. Oh, we're right here. Hey, stop. You're all good. You never offended me, buddy. You're good. Yeah, it's just, you know, even Cynthia's apology made me think. I mean, I've always referred to you as Rev or Wraith. Then she started calling you Max, and then I followed suit. Sir, we arrived on the Nal Shaddan system. Voyager sends Admiral Tubok's regards and says they're ready for you as soon as you move into transporter range. Understood? Let's meet with Voyager. We're going to transport you to Voyager as soon as you're ready. Let's do it. Well, while we load in here, let me go get some more Dr. Pepper. And I'll be switching to beer. Come here, Captain Kirk. And of course, I have loaded in the game right then and there. Transport complete. Oh, sorry, Captain. Sir, Admiral Tuvok has arranged to greet you in the transporter room. He wishes to speak to you about the device we recovered from Gull. Understood, I'll talk to Tuvok.
Welcome back to Voyager. We were about to begin studying the device you recovered from Gull's communication center. Since you have spearheaded much of our efforts here, I would like you to take the lead once again. Captain Kim and Seven of Nine are at your disposal. Talk with them if you need more help deciphering the device. When you finish your analysis, return to me for further orders. I will be here in the transporter room to see you off.
Understood, Admiral. I'll take a look at the device and engineering.
Glad you're here. We transported the device to engineering here so we could run all the scans and tests we could think of. The first thing we need to do is determine how it's communicating. We can't find any normal transmissions from it, but we're hoping you have some new ideas to bring to the table.
Agreed. Because you're not thinking logically. Scan, you study the device for a while and realize you must transmit a signal of some sort. None of the normal detection modes seem to have given any sort of feedback. You decide to investigate some of the more exotic transmission forms. Scan the device for subspace fields. The Vodwar are self-proclaimed masters of the underspace, a form of subspace in the Delta Quadrant, so you hypothesize that the device may be used to communicate directly to subspace. Of course. Your scans pick up a faint resonance. The device appears to be designed to communicate with a similar device located in subspace. Inform Captain Kim of our findings.
The device communicates with subspace. We should have guessed that.
No shit.
Now comes the hard part. We need to access the device's memory core. The engineering team here on Voyager is good, and I've heard your team is top-notch, but it might take more time than we have for either team to make a full analysis. We should have both teams give you their opinions on the device. If we work together, hopefully we can make a breakthrough.
Agreed.
You'll need to set switches on the device until we get solid readings. We'll be able to tell if switches are in the correct position, but not which switches. Good luck.
I'll go set the switches. You have the teams tell me what state the device is in.
The engineering teams tell me two of the switches are in the correct mode. Sir, I've consulted with both the engineers here on Voyager and your chief engineer. I am seeing green across the board. All the switches are in the correct position, and we now have access to the primary memory core of the device. Unfortunately, we're only halfway there. Now we need to access the secondary memory core to get full access to the data we need.
Access the secondary memory core.
The engineering teams tell me... The engineers... Looks like you did it again. All the switches are in the correct position, and we now have full access to the memory core of the device. 7 of 9 should be of assistance in accessing the memory banks of that device. She's in astrometrics, attempting to get a fix on the location of who or what is receiving these transmissions.
Excellent. I'll go see 7 of 9.
We have access to the databanks of the device. Very efficient work. From the data we have received so far, we will be able to pinpoint the exact transmission coordinates. However, it is possible that doing so may alert whomever is on the other end that we have reverse-engineered their technology. There are 3 likely ways to get at the information. I suggest further analysis to determine the best course of action.
Very good. Analyze. Hit time to probe defenses. The device determined if you attempt a brute force intrusion, you get a better than average chance of getting information without setting off alarms. A cryptic query. Feel security close to trip. Okay, so brute force. Your brute force intrusion of the database seems to have done the trick. No unusual activity is detected. And you have a location in real space where you can enter a subspace near the transmission location, the Nel Shaddan system. Now you have the location of the transmission desk point. You should speak to Admiral Tuvok. Alright, back to the transporter room.
Fascinating. Excellent work. With this location, we may be able to finally reveal who gave the Vaudoir their advanced technology and why the neural parasites appeared again in this time and place. Commander Jarak of the Romulan Republic has requested to join you on this operation. Her own analysis of the device has shown that the Romulans have had some contact with the creators of this device, a race known as the Ilachi. She will meet you in subspace at the given coordinates.
Very good.
Finally, Voyager's emergency medical hologram, the Doctor, will be assigned to your crew. His knowledge of the Delta Quadrant races may prove invaluable. He's not much of a combatant, but should prove useful.
Understood, Admiral.
Hello again.
Looking forward to our mission together, as am I. Ready to beam back to the ship, Captain. And that's not Tarsi. One to beam back.
Giggity giggity. Giggity goo. Stick around.
Welcome back, Almat. It's been a while, my friend. How are you doing? Hi, Father of Latex. I'm not the Father of Latex. Sir, we successfully transitioned into subspace. The RRW Lucette should be arriving any moment. Looks like Gull's communications were going to an Ilachi outpost station. It's still active, sir. I'm picking up several Ilachi ships in the area. I have an interview on Friday. Wish me luck. Good luck, my friend. Go to Yellow Alert and keep an eye on those Ilachi ships.
Greetings. This is Commander Jarak of the RRW Lisette. When we learned that the Ilachi were involved, I requested to shadow you on this mission. I know your experience with the Ilachi is limited. The Romulan Republic, however, has an extensive history with this race.
I already know who the Ilachi is, so I'm just going to say, happy to have your support. I doubt I'll need much any more information on the Alachi, though.
All right. We'll follow your lead here. We're seeing three patrol groups. Recommend we eliminate them before we board the station.
Ship is here to defend the outpost.
And I'm on Bosch battleship. So other than that, have any other good news? Ready to transport you to station as soon as you're ready? Let's do it.
Good. You found a breathing apparatus. That should take care of that nasty cough.
We arrived at the outpost station, sir. And a doctor has offered to accompany us. Wow. Good news might come after the interview. All right. And a doctor has offered to accompany the away team to offer his extensive knowledge of the Delta Quadrant. In addition, Commander Jirok has taken an away team from the Lisette to another part of the facility. She wants to speak with you before we begin, Commander Jirok.
I was thinking we should split up and cover as much of the facility as we can, unless you have a better idea.
Doctor, what's your take on the situation?
This is obviously an Alachi facility. What I know about them comes from the Romulan Republic's databases.
I mean, don't fret. As we examine just this location. Be
the
yourself.
Air here is suitable for the Alachi, which means that you may find breathing difficult. I, of course, do not have that problem. If you have an environmental suit, or even some sort of rebreather, you will be fine. If you don't, keep an eye out for something that could help filter out the toxins. These are Solanae tables. I've read the Enterprise D's reports about them.
Oh, that's right, I can't assimilate them. I'll try my best. I hope I get the job. Yeah. We hope so, too. Oh, I did assimilate him. Good. I thought I could.
Iconian gateway on New Romulus. The Solanae kidnap victims through subspace for their brutal experiments. If they are somehow connected to the Alachi and the Badwar, this is beginning to make more sense. If I had to guess, there must be a stasis room nearby. We should find it and rescue anyone in there who can still be saved.
Very good.
Up your shaft.
I already got you covered there, Alma. Well, thank you for reminding me to take a drink.
It looks as if they are converting their captives
into more. Surprised you didn't see me already take a drink there, buddy.
If my readings are correct, there are several individuals here who have only just begun the conversion process. We can save them if we beam them back to your ship.
Very good. I want to see the ass. Want to hear a good joke? Yeah, what's your joke? You'll see my arse when I get up in a minute to go grab a beer.
We're transporting you to a Romulan ship in orbit. You're going to be fine.
Why did the toilet paper roll downhill? Why?
This is no way for a proud Klingon warrior.
Get to the bottom. Oh, Jesus.
We'll catch him up immediately. Everything will be fine, Mr. Dre. We'll beam you directly to safety. Ah, Ah, a Hazard. Stay calm. We'll get you the medical attention you need. Transport the Stalaxian directly to sickbay.
I have some jokes, but they're not TOS friendly.
You'll be back on duty before you know it. One to beam up. A Kazon? Even the Borg won't assimilate a Kazon. Well, the Solanae are definitely involved. I believe I have everything I need from this area. We need to keep moving if we hope to meet up with Commander Jarak. The door is unlocked now. We should keep going.
Right back, gonna go get some snacks. Alrighty. I'll wait for your return to get up and go get a beer. Careful, Commander.
A prison break? Maybe I should go back to the ship.
Oh, you're fine, Doctor.
Neural parasites. This must be where the Vodwar were implanted with those mind-controlling bugs. Neural parasites. Just as I suspected. Did you know that several Starfleet officers were infected by these in the mid-2360s? The Enterprise logs from that era are fascinating reading if you ever have a few dozen hours to spare.
I'll look at them later. Doctor, continue, please.
If Gaul and the infected Vodwar were communicating with this station, it stands to reason that this may be the facility where the Bluegill implantation takes place. We should definitely investigate further. If we can find the implantation room, then I should be able to analyze their equipment and gather more information. I don't believe it. The empirical evidence is right in front of me, but I'm actually having difficulty processing this information.
What is it?
This tech, this whole facility, it's Iconian. There are variations on the norm, of course, because of the Solanae and Alachi influence, but I see distinct signs of their presence throughout the facility.
Iconians here too?
The Iconians, as we know them, rarely reveal themselves. The only known interaction with an Iconian in modern history took place on Kronos when... Wait, you were there! I don't need to explain that situation again. As I was saying, the Iconians don't like to act directly. They use servitor races, like the Alachi and the Solanae, to cause chaos in their name. And the neural parasites, they've bioengineered. Rather like the Founders created the Jem'Hadar, but sophisticated enough to control another species, and with much less free will. The parasites are a weapon.
What about the Vodwar? Were they active before the Iconians revealed themselves?
When Voyager revived the Vodwar, their technology was outdated compared to what other powers in the Delta Quadrant had at that time. Even the Kazon outdid them. But now, Vodwar technology is cutting edge. The only way they could have advanced so far, so fast, was by aligning themselves with someone else, with the Iconians. The Vodwar got their tech upgrades from them, but they also got the neural parasites. The parasites gave the Vodwar power, but they gave the Iconians control. They were ultimately the ones pulling the strings. This entire war has been against an enemy we didn't even see.
That's the information we needed to find. Let's meet up with Commander Jirok and get off this station. I'm back with a salad. That's not a snack. Captain Kirk, I need to go get a beer. Thank you, Captain. I had to keep my 98 kilogram sexy body giggly giggity. You just wanted to see my fat ass. That's all you wanted. Yes, sir. At least you admit it. By the way, what kind of beer is that? Skol.
But it's quite advanced.
Well, let me go to the full screen here. Skol. Never seen a white beer before. It's malted beer. It's not made with hops.
These parasites aren't a natural species.
I can't do a hoppy beer.
They look engineered.
Sir, I've taken some quick readings of the Lachi. They're showing the same energy signatures as the parasite-enhanced vodware, but they're fluctuating. The Lachi will be phasing in and out of vulnerability. We can beat them, just have to pick the right moment. Understood. Understood. We'll be ready for them.
Maybe we should avoid any potential contact with the prisoner. I think I've seen enough combat for today.
Too bad, Doctor. We're going.
Humans, always showing up when you're least expected.
Oh, I should shine myself in a minute.
Iconians want me to leave.
What would you think, make you think about that? Welcome back there, Rev.
Their tenacity is almost admirable.
Oop, gotta grab my loot.
Looks like you could use a hand.
Yes, we could.
And now we have their leader's attention. Okay, because I know
Ahmat wants to see this. I should make some routines for it. And an outfit check. And I did forget to shine myself earlier.
Giggity giggity. Giggity goo.
Oh, Jesus, I'm not really. Right when I'm doing it with my pants. There you go, I'm not. Okay. Ladies, stand down. No catfighting.
I should kill you where you stand. It would be justice for all the lives you've destroyed.
Calm down, Jirok.
And if you do, You'll never learn about the Iconians. I've been here for months. I've seen enough to know you need my help.
That could be very valuable information, Commander Jirok.
Fine. You interrogate her. I might get a little carried away. But she returns with me to the Lisette when you're finished here. Sela is a prisoner of the Romulan Republic. Your government can go through official channels if they want to talk to her.
I'm gonna touch myself. Oh, come on, Ahmad! I should time you out for that comment. Agreed, you take custody of herself once we're done.
You and this Sela person seem to have some history.
Not so fast.
I'll leave you to speak to her.
You have the weapons, but I have the information. If you want to learn what I know, you'll need to keep
the
rebels under control. You've stumbled into
something. I was wondering if you're gonna come in here tonight.
Than you're prepared to handle. I'm the best ally you have.
Talk, then I'll decide what happens to you.
I assume you already know where you are. Both the Alachi and the Solanae serve the Iconians. The Alachi are their warriors, and the Solanae are their scientists. They're the ones who created those creatures implanted into the Badoir.
The neural parasites, why did the Iconians use them here, but not on the Tal Shiar?
Hakiv joined the Iconians out of faith. He thought the Iconians would create an empire he could rule. That did not go as planned. This time the Iconians wanted to control their puppets. When the Vaudoir
How many beers make you drunk?
Their enemies,
quite a bit.
Gave them the parasites. The Vaudoir had strength, but also strings.
And don't strings ask me to do it while I'm gaming because I'll never get drunk.
I'm sure you had something to do with that.
Yes, alongside alliance of the Roman Republic and the Klingon Empire.
All three of you working together?
Two for you, Jeru? Damn.
The world has changed.
You need to upgrade those numbers.
Absence. Or were the Vaudoir that much of a threat to the Alpha Quadrant?
Actually, we're in the Delta Quadrant now.
That explains some things. I'd love an escort back to the world at large, but I have a feeling you have some questions first.
I don't have any questions, but I expect you'll answer some before your trial.
Will I be taken into your custody? Or will I be left to Tiaru's tender mercies?
We've agreed that in the spirit of cooperation, Commander Jirok will take custody. She's under strict orders. To deliver you directly to the Alliance Command, you will not be harmed. To Jiru from Ahmad, I've never been drunk before, because I can't drink much. Once a year, maybe. Jiru used to drink loads of... But single parent, last 7 years, so no drinking. I understand
Very
that.
Very well. It's not like I have a choice in the matter, do I?
Lisette, one to beam up. We're finished here, Captain. Seal us safely on the brig of the Lisette. Though I would think there will be a lot of negotiations between the Republic and the Federation before we know what will happen to her. Until then, we should report our findings to Admiral Tuvok and Alliance Command. Agreed. Let's go home.
Empress Sela in our brig. When she was taken by the Iconians last year, many of my people thought she would get away with her heinous crimes against the galaxy. With her in my brig, I am happy to know that is no longer a possibility. Of course, I understand that the Romulan Republic's claim on her is not unique. Her crimes are against all of the Alpha Quadrant. To that end, I will ensure that she be made available to all the Alliance leaders for interrogation and debriefing.
Well, that wasn't exactly what I'd call a walk in the park. At least we know exactly how the Iconians were controlling the Vaudoir. And you've certainly put a crimp in their plans. On the upside, as a photonic life form, I'm immune to any attempts at subversion by neural parasites. I'll see to the care of the captives we've rescued. In the meantime, it sounds like you and the Romulan Republic Command have a lot to talk about. Sela certainly has a story to tell. But should we believe all of it? I'll put a bug in Admiral Janeway's ear about the situation. That was a joke, by the way. You're going to be busy. Don't overdo... Oh, who am I kidding? Command officers never take their doctor's advice. Just remember that you're not in this alone. Good luck. I suspect things are starting to get...
Thank you, Doctor. Sir, the fleet has sent intelligence ships to comb the outpost for more information on the Nicodian involvement. We're cleared to return to normal space at your command. Let's get out of here. And I think I'm going to get a snack myself because dinner is not lasting long. Should have thought about that. Jeru, Emerald Drainly, Dis, She's, Bot, Get Lost, in Voyager. What? Amat, I got another joke, wanna see? As long as it's TOS friendly, Amat. What am I eating? Pretzels. I'll say one thing for Celia, she puts a scheme together, she doesn't think small. For now, her fate lies in the hands of the Diplomatic Corps. Starfleet will be in touch once they learn more.
There's something interesting I'd like you to look into.
Don't know what TOS policy is, so I'm not going to write it. Put it in my Discord. Send me a direct message. Oh, that's right. Dust to Dust is next. Actually, go ahead and write it here.
We have a situation on Kabali Prime. You and I were both asked by name to help. All that I've been told is that the Vodwar have launched a large offensive and have retaken the area in front of their temple, the place where they keep unconscious Vodwar stored. They need our help to retake the area.
Just write it here. Here, I'm out.
I have a feeling something else is going on. Can you help with the situation?
On my way, Captain. Yeah, that's okay. I've heard that one before, actually. So, actually, while we are flying here, let me do this real quick. Yeah, you can write it here, Amat. Okay, so Drew, how do you catch a bra with a booby trap? So, as some of you may have noticed, I did put in two videos in Ms. Unique Style's Discord server. No, that's not what I want. That's what I want. And it's the reenactment I'm going to go to this weekend, coming up. This one happens to be from 2008. I know it's a little blurry, but this is me right here. You can't really hear me too much, but in the next video you will. Are they real guns? They are historical firearms. Because of Twitch reasons, no. But we're not firing live ammunition. Well, let me just say this, they are fully operable. Okay, in this video, you will actually be able to hear me. I am in the opening couple seconds. It is very fun. I'm not. So that was me right there in the background. Okay, for Twitch reasons, I will not share any more, but they are on Miss Unique server under, and stuff like that. You can see the whole thing. No police around? We are the police. As a matter of fact, I am military police. Bruh. Yeah. I didn't know that said I'm up. Yeah. There's a lot of things I don't really say, and you should do that. Drew, they are real guns.
The breach is widening.
Cool, my mate was in the British MP for 25 years. Nice.
I just need a minute to.
What does it mean, MP? Military police.
The Vaudois are making a new push into the system, and we could use your help. The Rhode Island is assisting the new Kabali flagship Samsar, but you know the Vaudois. They're relentless.
Why are the Vaudois still attacking the Kabali?
Ask them. If you can get one of them to have a reasonable discussion. Eldex has been less than cooperative since Gaul's death. We know he's leading the remaining Vaudois forces, and there's no signs that the neural parasites are still influencing them, which is the only good news. The Vaudois won't stop their assaults until the Kabali surrender the remaining stasis pods, but the Kabali government refuses to do so unless the Vaudois agree to peace talks. We're at an impasse.
Understood. I'm on my way, Captain Kim. Initiate emergency saucer set. Saucer.
So quickly. I'm still not sure what happened. All I know is that we lost contact with the temple, and several hours later a large Vodwar fleet attacked. However, I'm still not sure if the Vodwar have entered the temple. If they have, they may already be reactivating their soldiers in stasis. We're safe here, for now.
Amat to Jeril, you are Scottish, right? Yes, he is.
No one can enter the temple, and the Vodwar are seizing
and Scottish.
The surrounding area.
We need to take it back, Captain Kim, Hanson, Titanian. The three of us are going in with an away team.
Sounds like a plan. I've located a safe area in the trenches for transport. My team and I will go down first and secure the area. See you there.
Will Voyager be coming to help us?
Voyager is currently on a high-priority operation in Vodwar-controlled space. Any comm chatter could give away their position. Whatever they're doing, Tuvok says it's important. But that's all I know.
Understood, Hanson Titanian. Can your team aid us on the ground?
My officers and I will join you. The Samsar will return to the dock with a small repair team, but I'm sending the majority of my crew to the city. We cannot allow the Vodwar to take control of it as well. Our flagship will be of no use to us if the planet is lost.
The Cynthia Hartwigson and the USS Rhode Island will secure the system against any additional Vodwar ships. I had the coordinates of Captain Kim and his team on Kabali Prime, sir. Hanson Titanian and his away team will meet us there. I'm ready to beam down. Yes, I am.
The Kabali forces are spread thin, and the Vodwar are making a push toward the temple. If I may, I have a suggestion for our plan of attack.
I'm out to Drew. I've seen two Scottish people on a tram before, and I knew they were speaking English, but I couldn't tell what they're using. Using understandable English. Yeah, like the Irish, they have their own unique brand of English. Definitely not using the Queen's English. Tell me your plan, Captain.
Hanson Titanian and his team will attack the outer area of the trenches, making their way to the temple.
Very strong accent. Yes, they have.
The opposite end of the trenches and support the remaining Kabali soldiers there. While they're holding the flanks, your team and I will push through the center and strike the Vodwar in the temple courtyard. Your thoughts?
Agreed, Hanson Titanian. Do you have any objections?
None. My team is eager to prove themselves. You and your allies have set quite an example for us to live up to. We'll support the forces at the other end of the trenches and then make our way to the temple. Hopefully, we'll be able to meet up with you before the final assault.
Very good, let's move out.
We have to help those Kabali.
Thank you.
get these Kabali patched up before more Vodwar get here.
I'm not much of an accent, and Edinburgh is the capital. But north and south, I can't understand some of them. What is this link here, Amat? Oh my god, you're living in Edinburgh? Yes, he is. Such a beautiful city. It's a city I want to see someday.
Here they come. Take out that drop pod.
When you live here, it's just traffic all day. Think about Scottish accent, okay? Yep. I know that one all too well.
Let's take them down.
Take out that Vodwar drop pod, and then keep moving. We're almost there.
I really hate this fucking mission.
Our scouts report that the temple is heavily defended. We still have some Vodwar attacking our flanks, but my soldiers insist they can keep them occupied long enough for us to retake the temple. Are you ready for the final push?
It sounds like there are other areas of trenches that can use the help.
There are other areas of the trenches in need of aid. My team and I could go help them while Captain Kim and his team stay with you. Or, if you think you can assault the temple alone, Captain Kim will rendezvous with his officers as well. However, I highly recommend you bring all of us in for your attack on the temple.
Oh, that's the British Parliament. They are mad, yes. My team and I will attack the temple alone. You and Captain Kim are needed elsewhere.
Are you sure you want to try to retake the temple alone?
Yes, my team and I can handle this. The Scottish have a passport or a British passport, UK passport, more than likely. I watched that video many times. Oh yeah, so have I. Yeah, we're British, just have the local government to control sending and tax us more. Yep.
The temple was secure, and the doors are still locked, which means the Vodwar didn't break in. Let's see. Okay. I've seen this sort of algorithm before. I'll have the door open in no time. After that, we can figure out what happened to the temple's security system.
Yep, I'm on. Good, how's it standing? Do you need support out here?
I don't deny that we'll need support. My team is one of the few still intact. Captain Kim's away team should meet up with us soon, but we don't know what kind of numbers we'll be up against. However, the temple itself should be free of Vodwar. If I may suggest, perhaps only you and Captain Kim should enter, and your officers can stay here and help us hold the area.
Very well. Our away teams will help defend the temple while Captain Kim and I investigate inside. Don't worry, Captain. We'll hold this area while you're inside. Are you ready to go? Yes, I am.
At least all the Vodwar here are in stasis pods. Let's take a look around. I want to know why the Kabali lost control of their security systems.
Sounds good. Keep an eye out for anything suspicious.
That's not true. According to these readings, the occupant of this module is me, but the name on it is Ket. Must be a computer glitch. Could be a symptom of a bigger problem, but whoever was in this pod is gone now. Looks like it was open before the problem started. Hold on. I'll access the temple security footage. Maybe that can show us something.
Let's see what's in the security footage.
That's
the security footage you
got.
Only
me.
Pain and suffering you will
what
find.
From over 30 years ago. What in the world?
Stay back! Are you with the Vidians? What do you want from me?
Ketten, you have to
what?
Calm down.
No drink left?
My name is
Jim. Oh, I got a drink.
I'm here to help you.
That's not my name. Where am I? Where is Voyager? I need to contact my ship.
Wait, come back.
Chitlayan. And me? Hold on. There's more security footage. This is the last thing that was recorded.
Voyager, this is Ensign Harry Kim. If you get this message, I'm in an unknown alien prison.
Be right back, 5 minutes. Okay.
And I'm looking for a way out. I'll send another message with my coordinates as soon as I can. Come find me.
That was me. From over 30 years ago, in my old Voyager uniform. And they're turning me... him into a Kabali. They knew. This whole time I've been here, they knew. And Lindsay, Jitlaya, she knew. I know I've had a difficult time accepting the Kabali, but they keep too many secrets. They should have told me. Told us about this.
Harry, are you okay?
I'll be okay. A little shaken up, but Captain Janeway once told me we're Starfleet officers. Weird is what we do, and this certainly applies.
So what's your opinion of the situation?
From what we saw on the security footage, it looks like the other me has taken control of the entire base. That's not too surprising. Not only does he have all the knowledge of a Starfleet officer, the rebirth process transformed his brain. The Kabali's six-lobed brains give them natural abilities in mathematics, physics, wave phenomena, everything he'd need to know to do this. He's still wearing his comm badge, though. I can tap into it. You should try talking to him first. Try to calm him down and convince him to surrender.
Don't you want to talk to him?
Not yet. He's already scared and confused. Seeing me before he gets his bearings, it will just make things worse.
Agreed, I'll talk to him.
Starfleet! Wait, I don't recognize you. You're not from Voyager. And your uniform? This is a trick. I don't know who you really are, but stay away from me. I don't want any trouble. I'm just trying to get back to my ship. You can tell whoever you're working for that Captain Janeway's coming back for me. She won't leave anyone behind.
Harry, we're here to help. This isn't a trick.
He's severed the comm link, but I've got a lock on his coordinates. He's deep in the base, down in the old Vaudoir tunnels that even the Kabali don't enter very often. And he's locked down all the main corridors that lead to his location. There's a way, though. There's emergency climbing equipment here. The Kabali put it in a few months ago in case they lost power during the Vaudoir attacks. We could use it to cross the chasm and get closer to where he is.
What will you be doing?
I'll be right behind you. But it's time to see if I can talk some sense into the other mate. He wants to contact Voyager, but if he does, he'll reveal their position. Unless we stop him, Harry either ruins Voyager's mission and possibly gets them killed or captured, or he finds a ship, sets a course for their coordinates, and gets blasted by the Vaudoir.
Why can't we just use the transporter?
Good idea. Kim to Rhode Island. We need an emergency transport to... Kim to Rhode Island. Can you hear me? Kim to Jatanian. Kim to...
I can't get through to my ship either.
He's locked out external comms. Probably wants to stop anyone left in here from calling for help. I'm afraid the zip lines are the only option. Unless you can fly.
Understood. I'll see you on the other side of the chasm.
I know you're confused, but you have to trust us.
What is this? Another me? You expect me to trust a shapeshifter? Stay back! I'm warning you!
The circuits are completely fried. Let's find another door.
Okay, let's go find another door.
He's trying to override it again. Give me a second. Let's keep going. It looks like he's modified the empty stasis pods to send out bursts of electricity. Tricky. I might be able to slow it down from here, but we can't stop what he's done without access to the main console, which is on the other side of the room. I'll stay here and do what I can to delay the bursts, but you'll have to get past them to shut them down.
Stay here, I'll get to the console and shut this down.
Now. Got it. You'll need to move through when they're in their disabled state.
Who are you? Why do you keep trying to stop me getting back to my ship?
I'm you. Harry, this isn't going to be easy to explain.
Liar! You can't be!
Power failures? The proton bursts? There were two Voyagers.
Two Voyagers? Yeah, right. How would that happen?
It was the spatial scission. Think, Harry. You know it's theoretical.
I'm not to Drew. I am a very curious person. Cowboy know me, and I am dying to hear your accent right now. I believe he does not have a microphone. At least that's what he told me last time.
We should keep moving.
Do me a favor, type in exclamation point socials. Let me see if that's working.
Jaglia, are you okay? How did... General Cunell said there wouldn't be any more secrets.
I'm okay. Harry? I didn't know they'd send you.
Nice, it's all working now.
Harry, I don't think this is the time.
How
Thank
long
you,
Giroux.
Did you
know?
I didn't know what I was doing.
Oh, I should have put it in Discord.
That's what you're asking. We need to stop Ketton. He locked the rest of my team away. They're safe, but trapped. We're the only ones who can help him. It's good to finally meet you. My people are in your debt. We need to move fast. Ketton's not in his right mind. The rebirth process can be difficult under the best conditions, and I don't know. Maybe humans resist the process more than other species. It took me a long time to accept who... what I was.
And he's having the same problem?
Yes. He doesn't know what happened. I tried to tell him, but he still thinks it's 32 years ago, Voyager is lost in the Delta Quadrant, and we're in league with the Vidians. He's desperate to get home. When Ketton started tampering with the security devices, he tripped an alert that was sent to the Vadwar. They think their soldiers are waking up, which is why they're so desperate to get inside. He's putting us all at risk. We need to
Twitter and Instagram links aren't working? They should be. Oh, I see the problem. Or at least the Instagram. Okay, I see the problem with everything. I can't spell today. Okay. Okay, I may have to reset the stream. I'll check that out later. We'll do all we can.
Action item 238. Resurrect your best friend and give him a second chance for a long life. It's not working out so well, is it?
He's trying to contact Voyager. Is that possible from here?
I'm not familiar with everything in this area. We rarely go down this deep. There are still Vadwar traps here that make exploration dangerous. However, as far as we understand, this facility was intended as a final shelter for the Vadwar. It would make sense that they would have had a way to contact the outside world. But if Ketton finds a communication device and uses it to contact Voyager,
The Vodwar will hear his message too.
At least my TikTok works. What's your analysis, Captain Kim?
Ketton is a danger to himself and to Voyager. If he succeeds in this gambit and contacts Voyager, he'll draw every Vodwar in the sector to their coordinates. I can't allow that. We have to stop him. He's putting Tuvok and his crew in danger.
Then we need to save them both.
Just let me get back to Voyager!
I hate this fucking part.
It looks like this used to be a server room of sorts. But it's not like one I've seen before. All this is computer storage. And it's massive. 900-year-old Vodwar technology. It's a lot different from anything we have back home. And he's using this to completely block us out. Terrific. There doesn't seem to be a way around this.
Can you lower whatever these things are?
I'm sure Jitlaya and I can figure out something, given enough time. But if I was on the other side of this, and I am, I'd be trying to stop anyone from moving these. There has to be some sort of reset command. But with our luck, it's on the far side of the maze. Jitlaya and I will keep Ketton from blocking you in. But you'll need to get through this and reset the servers so they return to their start position.
Great, you keep working on it. I'll start trying to find a way through.
Think I can make you a door? Wait here. You're good to go. I'll monitor the area from here.
I'm sorry this is how we had to meet again, Harry.
That makes two of us. You should have told me.
And if we had, what would you have done?
I don't know. But I had the right to know you had a copy of me in cold storage.
Are you saying that?
Oh, here is the first ring.
Right to rebirth?
I don't know. This is all a lot to take in at once.
I know it is. Imagine how Ketton feels.
Finally, I found someone! I got separated from everyone
idea.
When all the craziness
Confused,
started, and I was trying
angry,
to find my way to a
isolated.
Panel to call for help when this maze just rose up around me. Now I have
Ketton
no
died
idea what
to save
do.
Voyager.
I'll do what I can to help you.
Thank you.
He doesn't even realize what happened.
And I know this is a terrible way to meet a potential captain, but do you have any
He understood the risks,
on board your ship?
And he accepted them.
General Cunell is planning an officer exchange program, and I'm one of the first recruits. We want to learn from the Alliance,
Did
as
really?
Well as thank you for all
Think
you've done for our world.
More,
I'd be honored if you allow me to join your crew, as soon as I find my way out of here, of course.
Starfleet would be honored to have a Kabali
Starfleet
on the Cynthia Hartwood
duties. I understood that then, and I do now.
I seem to remember...
And here is the second part. That's good.
All we wanted was to get home.
Yeah, I was scared back then. I missed my family. But I did what I had to do to get back to them.
You got back home, Harry. You did what you had to do. Ketton didn't get that chance.
And I'm sorry for him. But is this better?
He has a new life. Ketton can be anything or go anywhere he wants now.
as a Kabali. He's not who he was anymore.
Thank you, I need a stretch.
And is that a worse option than being dead?
Scheiße.
No, of course not. But I should have been able to choose.
Why? He's your duplicate, Harry, but he's not you.
I know what he would want.
Just gotta make sure I was going the right way.
Do ya? Because you can't even convince Ketton to drop this maze and talk to you.
Was I already
here?
When
you put it that way, maybe we are different. He's being so stubborn.
Good night, guys. Have fun. Thank you, Jer. I'm out.
He's allowed to be both.
Have a good night. This is so maddening. I'm right close to the damn
edge. Thought you could handle all my tricks, old man. We're working on it, kid.
Oh my lord, I'm so close to the fucking edge.
Take all the time you need. You know, you could make this easier. Drop the maze. Talk to us. Why? So you can lie to me again? I'm not lying to you. I know it's a lot to take in, but... Treat me like a child. If you're not lying, then you stole my life. It was my life, too. I didn't steal anything. That's great. So you get to do and be everything I wanted, and I get stuck in a pod? My life hasn't exactly been everything I always wanted. Getting home wasn't easy. But you did get home. I didn't. I understand
how you feel,
but I cannot change what happened. And if you could, you'd what? Trade places with me? I can't do that. All I can do is try to help you now. Stop lying to me! You don't want to help me!
Oh my god, there it is. About fucking time.
You know that's not true. It's not working. But if I do this, maybe I can buy some time. We have him. Kenton, cornered. Without those platforms, though, we have no way to reach him. It's insane. He's manipulating these old defense systems like he's in a Captain Proton Hollow.
I need you and Jet Li to figure out how to get these platforms operational again.
We have command codes that allow us to interface with the older Vaudoir technology. We've never seen the need to replace systems that still work.
All right, look alive, team.
It looks like
welcome in, Kyle.
Hey, what's
I'll
up?
Need to override his changes.
Not much, you.
The best I can do right now is to expose.
You just missed your boyfriend.
Each platform.
Not my boyfriend, dude.
Sorry. He goes after me today, though.
Oh yeah.
He wanted to see my shiny ass.
Ha ha ha.
At the start, Captain Kim, does that give you anything to work with?
Yes.
Yes, Drew, he wanted to see my shiny ass.
For any changes in the platform's functionality, but I can modify the central power cores to react to energy weapons. If you shoot the cores, you'll be able
to
power
up
the platforms and force them open.
Checking to see if my dailies are up.
A short window before he resets them.
Yes, it is.
If we want to do this, Jet Li and I will stay.
I join you, but I am doing dust to dust.
And there's still that matter of the field protection.
And yes, I did get the Kabali Bridge Officer.
Oh, nice.
Open to suggestions, Captain Kim.
When the Kabali first found this room, the old Vaudoir EPS systems were too degraded to handle all the power. They installed regulators throughout the area as a stopgap measure until they could replace the conduits. Basically, it meant that even if one conduit failed, the network would stay active. Those regulators are still in place, and we can use them to get to Ketten.
What's your plan?
Jet Li has command codes we can use to overload the regulators. The chain overload will generate a wave of power that will build until it overloads the generators Ketton is using to maintain the field protecting him. Get these codes into four of the consoles and it will short out the field. Once he's distracted, Jet Li and I can reset the platforms to their normal state.
Anything else I need to know?
One last thing. Jet Li and I can run this program three different ways. The one that would buy you the most time before the platforms are reduced also takes the most of our attention. There's also a balanced option, or, if you don't like either of those, I can spend most of my time trying to counter Ketton's plans. What do you want us to do? Whatever we choose will determine... Are you
Let's
certain
be safe.
You want us... Give us a few more seconds. The cores are exposed. It's your move now.
So how's your old knee doing?
Oh, interesting.
It's got me down again today.
Man.
He's trying to access
it buckled on me.
I'll keep an eye on him.
Guess we're just going to have to cut it off. I'll be down there with my knives.
I put my knee brace on today so I can get around the house.
Maybe that's what you need there, Bubble J. Okay, over the third obstacle. Now the fourth one's a bitch.
That's it. Keep giving me the codes. Whatever you're thinking of trying, don't. We're almost there. You keep saying that, but I'm still here.
I got my own throne.
Stand down before this gets any worse.
I got the most sword.
Worse? How can it get worse?
Yes, I made it through. God. Oh my lord, that's butt clenching. That's a pucker factor 10.0.
You're too late. I'm getting back to Voyager. No matter what.
I had to do the part of one where I had to go through all the cores.
Oh, yeah.
This is bad. Ketton used Jidlaya's command codes to access the Kabali flagship in orbit and transport himself to the bridge. Not only that, but he has Voyager's coordinates.
Well played. Thank you, Jeru.
The Vodwar will see it as an act of war. We'll lose Ketten, the Kabali flagship, and probably Voyager 2.
He won't stand a chance against the Vodwar, not alone.
Exactly. We have to stop that ship.
Agreed. I'll return to the Cynthia Hartwigson. You should get back to the Rhode Island.
I'm coming too. I helped find Ketten's body. I've watched over him during the rebirth process. It's my responsibility to help him now. Please, you must let me do this. I need to fix the mistakes I've made.
Very well, go with Captain Kim. I'll be on the Cynthia Hartwigson. Sir, Kabali has flagship just armed weapons and is powering engines. What are your orders? Transport me directly to the bridge. We're going after the Kabali ship. Yeah, so tomorrow I'm working on a friend's house, getting the siding done. And I
sounds
think Kyle,
fun.
Kyle has not disappeared.
Sounds like fun.
Yeah. So, in a little bit, I'll be stopping my stream, getting all my shit together for that, doing dishes, taking care of laundry, showering, washing the latex. All that happy horse shit.
I told you to stay away! Why won't you listen? I'm going to find Voyager, and I won't let you stop me. I can arm this ship. Don't make me do it. I don't want to hurt you, but I will if you keep trying to stop me from getting back to Voyager.
Voyager's enemy territory. If you go, they will die. Or you will die.
You're not giving me a choice. Computer, arm all weapons and fire! What was that? Like a disruption beam. He scrambled all of our systems for a second or two and then went to war. This is not good. He set a course for Voyager. His warp drive's damaged, though. He's only going warp 6, and I don't think he can push the engines any harder. Not without an engineering team. I know we can catch him. Then we just have to convince him to stop.
Setting a pursuit course.
You're actually annoying.
Give me one good reason why I can't contact Voyager. They're not on any secret mission in enemy territory. I found them. They're in something called Krenim space. I don't even know who the Krenim are. Voyager is trying to get home, just like me.
Harry, it's been 32 years. Tuvok commands Voyager now. A lot has happened. The Voyager's on a secret mission. If you expose them, they could all die.
Quit trying to confuse me. I know what year it is. I know who my captain is.
Look at the ship's logs. I am not lying to you.
Ketten's not responding to hails. But I think if I use the deflector dish to emit a pulse tachyon beam, I can disrupt his engines and force him out of warp. But he's going to be expecting something like that. Which is why I'll distract him with a bit of a light show while you send the real thing from your ship.
Start your distraction, we'll reconfigure our deflector dish.
He's out of warp and arming weapons. Get ready.
That is an interesting ship. on their corpse collectors and their new toys.
This dragon is over here.
But this is Hirogen space. Leave now. Leave the ship as a trophy. We'll see how well it performs in a hunt.
The ship is disabled. The hunt will not please you.
Perhaps. But wounded prey can be amusing as well. Or maybe I'll strip it and display its bones as a warning to intruders.
You leave me no choice. Red alert. Great, I'll transport with you to the bridge.
I'm going to. I have to see Kenton face to face. It's time to talk this out.
One to transport.
Maybe you should talk to him first. Try to calm him down. He's not in the mood to listen to Harry or me.
I'll do what I can.
Why are you trying so hard to keep me from getting home? I need to... I don't even understand what's going on anymore. Why do I look like this? Like them?
They're called Kabali. You are becoming Kabali too. Do you see the date in the ship's logs?
I saw the star date. What happened? How do I get back to Voyager? To my time? How do I get back to my life?
Harry, you died 32 years ago. The Kabali revived you, but you are Kabali. There is no going back.
I died. I can't remember. Why can't I remember? You're taking my memories from me. I won't. I won't forget. I can't forget Voyager. I cannot forget my friends.
And if you lose your memories, your friends will never forget you. But Voyager is part of your old life.
Kenton, you have to stop this. If you contact Voyager, I'm done listening to you. I just want to go home. I want my life back. The life you stole from me.
I understand. I wanted to be Ensign Lindsay Bauer. I loved my life, my friends, you. And then I died, and that life was gone. I tried to get it back, but I would have been living a lie.
So I should just give up who I am?
No, I'm saying that life ended. But now you have a chance to live a new one. I'm gonna be with you every step of the way. Action item 478. Help my best friend own the day. Every day.
Even with everything I've done.
Forgive him. We don't hold grudges against family.
I can't tell you what to do, Ken. But the Kabali will be there for you. And I'll do whatever I can to help. Would you tell me what happened? Voyager and how you got home. About Mom and Dad and Libby. I think I want to know. Of course I can.
Thank you for your help. Ketton is going to have a new life with us. A long and happy one where he can be whoever he wants to be. My people have been outsiders for so long. The other species don't understand us or what we have to do to survive. We want to reach out to them. Be a part of the Quadrant again.
And if Ketton decides he wants to explore the Quadrant again?
If Ketton decides he wants to leave Kabali Prime at some point, that's his choice. He can even rejoin Starfleet. But we will always be his family.
Fair enough, Captain Kim.
I'm happy for Ket. He gets a second chance at life. A different one than what he had planned, but that's the way life is. When I graduated from the Academy, I never thought I'd spend 7 years lost in the Delta Quadrant. Didn't think it would take me as long as it did to get my own command. Didn't think Lindsay and I would never. That's all in the past now. And it's made me the man I am today. Just like Ketton will be the man he's supposed to be.
I'm glad you see it that way, Harry.
I'm not letting the Kabali completely off the hook, though. Cunel told me there wouldn't be any more secrets, and then they kept this from me. If the Kabali want to be a part of the Delta Quadrant community, they need to be more forthcoming about who they're adding to their families. These men and women aren't getting a choice. Maybe rebirth is a gift, but it's a gift people should have the right to reject.
Agreed. Good luck, Captain. Cynthia Hartwigson is ready to leave whenever you are. Beam me back.
Ketton has been sent back to Kabali Prime to finish the process of rebirth. In the meantime, the Kabali have agreed to make their list of... This was very personal for me to deal with, and I'm glad I had someone like you at my side to help me through it.
You're welcome, Captain Kim. Alrighty, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me today. We have now finally finished the Delta Quadrant. I am so thankful because I'm sick and tired of hearing that same song. So let's go raiding, shall we? So, give Rev a nice gothic cowboy hello, and we'll see you later.